Hello, I'm Tim. I'm the PM for the package stage, and this is a demo of a feature that is now available on GitLab.com, but behind a feature flag. It's the Maven dependency proxy. Should be a fairly short demo. If you're interested in using this feature before the feature flag has been removed, just pop over into this epic. I'll link it in the video description as well, and just ping at trizzy and we'll get you set up. The other note is that currently you have to update the settings using GraphQL, but GitLab comes with a GraphQL editor and it's pretty straightforward to do. If you need any help, just let me know and we can get you set up. So I have this project here and I want to go to my package registry, right? I have some items in here already. I'm going to select all and I'm going to delete these for the sake of the demo. And then I'm going to go and open up the IDE, go into my POM file. And just to show you quick what's happening in the pipeline definition, the main thing that we're going to look at today is the deploy job, which basically pulls down all the dependencies for Maven, and then we'll publish them to the GitLab project. My settings file is just, it's using all predefined environment variables for authentication and plugging in my project ID. The one thing to note here, the difference in the URL compared to the existing Maven repository, you have to add this dependency proxy to the URL. And then I just have a simple POM file with my application and some dependencies. So I'm going to try and just bump these down one version. Okay. Then I'm going to commit these changes to master because it's my own project and hopefully nobody judges me. Okay, changes are committed. I'll just head over to my pipelines and I'll click on the deploy job. Hasn't started running yet. I'll pause for a second. Oops. Yeah, we had a bug, an error, and it's because I put in an incorrect version for this. So let's just check. Let's grab, I don't know, 582. Okay, I'm going to go back over to my project and to my. Actually, I'll pause and come back when the job's finished. Okay, the job succeeded this time. And let me scroll up and we can see where it's downloading. So you can see all of my dependencies are being downloaded through that dependency proxy URL. Let's head over to the package registry, and we should see those 11 packages here. Excellent. And so any of these you can click into, you can see which branch and which commit and job is responsible for this. You can always, of course, copy these installation fields, and you can access the actual files here. Okay, so what if I run the pipeline again? Now, and this time I'm not going to delete the packages from the registry, so it should run significantly faster if we go to that same deploy job. So last time it took 49 seconds. Let's try again. Okay, it finished this time in 40 seconds, so about a 16% improvement. And obviously, the more dependencies you have that are drawn from the cache, the more efficient it will be. Okay. that's it for the demo. If you have any questions, pop over into the Epic and let us know. Thank you very much for watching.